where we distributed it, which countries they distributed it to. One of the key aspects that a company like Coca-Cola has is trace. I know there's this tendency of wanting to share. We want to share the research that we've undertaken, be it a church, be it being the beer garden, right? Be it anywhere. The first thing you need to understand as an IP generator or innovator is there's something called trade secret. Right? And that trade secret is the difference between you and potentially a $1 million. So this IP is not registered in any office, no. It's a control mechanism that we have as an organization, as a faculty, as individuals. You have other external people coming in to research. They come to the University of Zimbabwe to research. You ask them, what do you want? And they tell you, don't pay us anything. Don't give us transport. Don't give us accommodation. They've never wondered, so why are they here? They need to extract as much as they can from you. And the unfortunate reality with us, perhaps at the universities, we give out. We give out, we freely give out as much information so that I can be respected as an academic. But what you are simply doing to me is you are giving me knowledge. Which is why I wanted to make my presentation very short. Because you will then take my knowledge and professionalize it. So trade secrets are a secret weapon. They should always be in the back pocket at any given time. Right? Be careful who you're talking to. Even if it's your fellow researcher in the same department, right? They may come up, you may come up with the idea. They may come up with the lab, the pencil in the lab. Right? And you may each other, like, what is it that you want? Plant varieties, plant breeders, and farmers' rights. That's another area of intellectual property. Right? The seed varieties that are created, those plant varieties, they also have their own protection. Right? This is the other discussion that we're going to have in the afternoon. What consists of a new variety? Breeders, the farmers, the agricultural institutes. Right? So you can already see where you are. You should be seeing where you are. Okay. Traditional knowledge, right? Systems. There is a lot of intellectual property that is being stored. In fact, if you ask me, the greatest tragedy that we ever experienced is Africa is not the resources that we were taking out. It's actually the knowledge that they took out. Right? When they said at Berlin Conference in 1885, if I'm not mistaken, if you ask me what the repartition is, the interface, they show gold, platinum, whatever other resources, there's one hidden resource that doesn't appear in any of those people. It's the IP, it's the traditional knowledge that they are now selling us. 21st century, we are now buying what they will extract. And they continue to extract it from us. Right? You find foreigners prepared to go down, right? Deep in the jungle, to live with my great man, right? For 2 months. And you ask him, what do you want? He says nothing. He doesn't want anything. But there is a lot of traditional knowledge, traditional culture that is what? Being exported and bring what made to us and so to us. So this is essentially intellectual activities on best practices, whether it be how the traditional indigenous people treat the disease. What the Vice Chancellor was talking about, the extraction from that particular root is what we should be looking for, so that we may be able to develop it and protect our own patterns. So there's a lot of traditional knowledge which is out there. You'll be sure. In online gaming, a big industry, right? I'm sure you all witnessed the FIFA World Cup, but not the physical one. There was an electronic one, right? So they developed a multi-billion dollar industry out of games. And some of the games, you'll be shocked. I know there's a game called Rory, right? Which you can download on some app if you go and you can play it. But that game is derived from our own traditional knowledge, right? And someone is coming, taking it, commercializing. So there are a lot of opportunities that we take for granted, right? Obviously, the most common example is the sand people. Right? So what happens to the sand people? The sand people have everything, they have the cactus, right? That cactus food that they eat, right? And they come, they do their investigations. They realize that these sun people, has anyone ever seen a sun person who weighs more than 60 kilograms? If you look at most of the sun people in their region, they are slim figures, they are tender figures, right? Why? They discovered that there is a certain element in the character's food that contributes to their nutrition and makes them slim, which we buy today as dried cubes. Right? So the traditional knowledge system of the Sun people was taken, went out of the country, came back, it has been commercialized, it's one of the biggest industries in the world. But that is also another discussion later on in the afternoon. So, before I close, there is a whole world of intellectual property. But remember, we say it's generic. You need to identify what intellectual property I'm dealing with. We will send you notes, we will send you so many things to read and all, but that doesn't work. What works is an issue to come from the heart. Right? You as an individual should go back today and identify what is my IP, what is my area of research. Right? And the moment we do that, we'll then be able to move on to the next discussion of how do I commercialize that IP. A lot has been said about funding. Right? We want the government to do this, we want and like my colleague said, the actual basic options, if you develop an entrepreneurial attitude as an individual, like Mshikashika has, right? Mshikashika has identified his problem. He needs to transport it, and he's going to transport at any cost, whether they are police, whether they are roadblocks, whether whatever in the way, he's going to move. But what are you doing as an academic, as an entrepreneur yourself? Are you going to wait for the university, for the supervisor? Are you going to wait for them so that you can make $1 million? Is my question. Right? So identify and understand the key aspects of intellectual property. So that is all that I have for you. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Mr. Sina. That's was very enlightening to also give us something to think about. Like he said, these concepts will actually be further developed after. So for those purposes, we are not going to have a discussions for the floor. I think it would be better for us to have discussions for the floor, but everything else is actually to clarify. So for now, I think we will take a tea break. And our tea break is actually